Hey everyone, in this quick video, I wanted to show you how you could add timestamps to your YouTube description. So if you ever seen a YouTube description that has timecode stamps, and when you click those stamps, it takes you to that part of the video, that's what we're gonna look at today. So let me jump to my YouTube page and let me go down to a video that's a little bit longer, because in longer videos, you wanna give people those cue cards to jump around the video. So let me go ahead and click that and let me go ahead and pause that video. So here I'm gonna press edit video to edit this description. And in the description tab, this is where we could put those time codes for us to jump around. And all you have to do is type in the time where you wanna jump into the video. So literally, if you wanted to go to 2 minutes and 55 seconds, that's all you gotta do is type that in. I usually like to put a description, so for creating a file, so I'll name it so the audience knows what they're gonna get, and I'm gonna press save. So when I press save, I could go back to my video here.
Hey everyone,
and now if I click this, it will take me to that part of the video, just like that, 255. It took me to that part of the video. Let me edit that again. So what you wanna do is you wanna create multiple timestamps just like this to give your audience the best points in the video to jump around, because maybe 12 minutes is too long and they're just looking for something specific. This gives your audience a better way to navigate. So if you wanted to take someone to 10 minutes, again, put 10 minutes. If you wanted people to skip the intro, you could do 0:34. That will take you to the 34 second mark. Let me save again and view the video one more time. So there we go. Now we got our 10 minute mark. So if I click that, it's gonna take me right to the 10 minute mark. If I click 34, it takes me to the 34 second mark. So it's a really great way to go back and forth between the different time codes. And I've been told that every time someone clicks one of these, it actually counts as a different view because they're jumping to the different part of the video. So if someone clicks this one and then this one, it counts as two views for your YouTube video. I hope you found this video useful. Please give it a like and subscribe to the channel for a lot more how-to videos on YouTube and tech. And I hope to see you on the next video. Thank you so much for watching.